This episode of Tekzilla is brought to you by domain.com.
At the Birdman tweets, at Tekzilla, can you do a comparison with DuckDuckGo to Google? They talk about being privacy-centered, but is it as good? Love the show. Thanks. And for those of you who have never heard of DuckDuckGo, it is a search engine.
Yay!
And it's kind of funny because, well, that's DuckDuckGo. Why is it black on your machine?
Oh, I just made it like
white
that.
On my machine. Okay.
I chose like, what? That. Default.
Well, it's kind of funny, right? So I did a basic search with, you know, HE351 VE Turbo, something that's on my mind right now. And it's kind of funny. Notice, okay, so we have shopping, we have sponsored sections, we have images, we have a YouTube video. Funny that lots of Google products are at the top of this. And then we have H351 VE Turbo Upgrade Diesel Bombers. And look at this, kids, DuckDuckGo. Okay, there is a sponsored link, which actually I think is, it would be really funny, is that AdWords. There's eBay, and then, you know, Turbo Talk. There's the Diesel Bombers link.
Yeah.
So there's definitely some similar search elements to it. Mm-hmm. You are the resident hackatrice, hacktress, hack maven, hack five person.
The what?
You're the hacker in the house. Is it secure? Is it safer?
So, it's definitely privacy centered. On their main page, their slogan is the search engine that doesn't track you. And their privacy page right here, it boasts a ton of information in normal human speak about how they use options like HTTPS and post request, which I totally get now that I've been writing Perl code. It's so awesome. And they've created exit nodes for Tor use well. So that's pretty nice too.
So you can literally anonymously search
search
engine.
Yeah. So you end up with no targeted search answers, no targeted ads, no saved queries. But with this comes a question though, will I still get good search results?
Well, and there's kind of two ways of looking at that. Because you took a much deeper look than I did at sort of DuckDuckGo versus Google. But it's kind of funny because if you've never done it, do some searching. If you spend a lot of time in Google, do some searching while logged into your Google account. Then log out of your Google account and do some
same
searches. Because you might find out that you get radically different results whether you're logged in as, say,
yes.
Shannon or Patrick or Michael or Bob or Wendy or yep. Harry or whoever else you can find to log in. That's where it gets really interesting.
Yeah, so I took DuckDuckGo and Google for a little test spin with the same search queries. So I tried searching for some terms that are very relatable mm-hmm. to me. So I searched for DEFCON, for Darren Kitchen, my co-host on Hack 5, for Tekzilla, for us. On Google, they all sent me data from my own friends, such as a tweet from Serafina, which was sent years ago about DEFCON, of all things. And I was like, how does that relate? It's so old. And Darren Kitchen's Google Plus updates, which I don't want to see those. I just want to see, you know, his profile, for example. Why would I want to see all his different tweets and things? So when searching Tekzilla on Google, I also get this creepy people also searched for a box. And I was like, ew, that's kind of weird and awkward. So on all three different occasions on DuckDuckGo, they sent me very generic links with a description bar at the top when available mm-hmm. of what a certain thing might be. So for example, if I searched for DEFCON in here, I would get this little bar up at the top that would give me a whole bunch of descriptions just to figure out which one I might specifically be looking for. And then I can click on that and be like, oh, the hacker convention. If I go to Google and search for DEFCON, and I am logged in right now, so I'll get DEFCON at the top, and then I scroll down. Oh, look, there's Serafina. Why?
Because you know her on the Google Plus, and that's another Google product.
It's so creepy.
Can you do stuff? I mean, one of the nice things about Google is being able to do math calculations and stuff like that. Do they have any of those sort of fun little hacks inside of DuckDuckGo?
Yeah, they actually do. So you can do math calculations on DuckDuckGo. You can do these really cool things called bang commands. So if I type in, let's see, I'll just do bang Amazon
shoes. I thought you said bang commands.
Like a shebang. Bang Amazon shoes.
Oh,
so
funny.
When I type that in, hit enter, it automatically brings up Amazon and searches for shoes. And they do some other little search answers as well. DuckDuckGo is also just as fast to give you answers as other search engines.
Well, there are a couple
of downsides to DuckDuckGo as well.
What's that?
So there is no monetary conversion. So if you put in like $2 and try to convert that to euro, it's not going to know what you're looking for. And there's also no good map answers. The first one I would get was like old school MapQuest. So no Google Maps answers whenever I
look on DuckDuckGo. So I go to maps.google.com.
Yeah, so I would go to maps.google.com and that
Or MapQuest.
and then be tracked. They do also have an Android and an iOS app for mobile use, which is pretty cool, but there's no Windows and no BlackBerry. Sorry, guys.
Sorry.
You can still make it the default on your PC or your Mac if you want to, so that's super simple. So, what my findings are is that Google rocks when it comes to finding specific searches that involve you or your friends, and it also wins when it comes to maps and movie times and conversions and things like that nature. So it has a lot of nice built-in features, but if doing a search that doesn't require some kind of flashy add-on in the search engine, use DuckDuckGo because you'll still get the same results or very, very close ones in no data collection while you're doing it.
No data collection, which means it's more private, kids.
When you buy a domain from domain.com, you get the power to influence and control what people find when they search for you online. No other domain extensions tell your story with the same trust of a .com or a .net domain name. .com and .net domain extensions inject credibility into your online presence, and who doesn't want to be credible? We like domain.com because they're affordable, they're reliable, and they're easy to use. A .com domain is only $9.99 a year, and a .net is only $8.99 a year. Plus, the folks at domain.com gave Tekzilla an awesome offer for even more savings. You can get 20% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use the coupon code Tekzilla at checkout. That's 20% off, aka big time savings. Don't forget to use the coupon code Tekzilla, and when you think domain names, think domain.com.